Thomas William Arthur Tate liked only English grub. He ate his tripe and onions when he came in from the pub. He flicked his cigarette ash on the carpet. His missus brought him tea and he'd say, top it. Thomas William Arthur Tate, a man of several facets, being in touch with the zeitgeist was not one of his assets. When he saw George W. on the news, he would crack another can and wonder who's he. You must appreciate that Thomas William Arthur Tate went morning on from Sundays right through Friday, saying things just weren't like this in my day. Thomas William Arthur Tate, a man of unseen talents, he thought the scales of justice had got woefully unbalanced. He mourned the downfall of a nation, blamed it on the younger generation. Thomas William Arthur Tate, a man of strong opinions about how we lost the empire and control of our dominions. When he had a new tirade to launch, he balanced a beer can on his paunch. He, in his armchair quite prostrately, Thomas William Arthur Tate, he'd never seen a government as weak as this one. They should hang asylum seekers. Thomas William Arthur Tate, not nice and that's official. If you're in any doubt about it, check out his initials. He said the young were slack and feckless, blamed it on political correctness. Thomas William Arthur Tate, he said he'd hate the nanny state, and when he was advised to give up smoking, he replied, you must be chuffing joking. Thomas William Arthur Tate spent his whole life in a chair. He claimed the world was run by commies, fags and fairies. He was no Socrates or Plato, just another narrow-minded couch potato. Thomas William Arthur Tate, to finish off the story, his chair at last collapsed, an apocalyptic snow. He let out, shook the pots and pans, surrounded by fag ends and cans, the remnants of a sedentary situation. He looked like a Tracy Emin installation. Thomas William Arthur Tate, he got up to the pearly gates, he found that they'd become quite democratic, been replaced by something automatic. There was no way he was getting in, he hadn't memorized his PIN, rang the helpline and was put on hold. Then a pre-recorded message told him, you're not going in, because you spent your whole life moaning. Thomas William Arthur Tate liked only English.